नियतिकृत नियमरहितां श्लाघैकमयीं अनन्य परतंत्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिं माधवी भारती कवेर जयति. विल स्टार्ट विथ समुच्चय अलंकार. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ समुच्चय अलंकार. एक्चुअली देर आर थ्री वेर देर इज असद्योग सद्योग एंड सदसद्योग. सो ही गिव्स अस थ्री एग्जांपल्स फॉर समुच्चय अलंकार. समुच्चय इज वेर वन there are two things for one karyam ekasmin sadake sthite sadhakantarani yatra sambhavanti. So tatsiddhi hetau ekasmin yatra anyat tat karam bhavet samuchayo asau. This is your first type of samuchaya that he says. There is another type of samuchaya also which involves guna and kriya. Here it is just a karyam and karanam. So tatsiddhi hetau for the siddhi, for the success of something, for one cause is there. Ekasmin sadhake sati, when one cause is present. Sadhakantarani yatra sambhavanti, where other causes are also given for an effect to come into existence. So prastutasya karyasya, for an effect. Ekasmin sadhake stite, one cause is enough, yet and many causes are given there as coming together for one effect. So prastuta, when we look at the examples, it will be more clear. Udaharanam durvaraha smara marganaha priyatamo dure mano manotyutsukam ati utsukam gadham prema navam vayo ati kadhinaha pranah kulam nirmalam stritvam dairya virodhi manmata suhrit kalah kritanto akshamaha नो सख्यश्चतुरा कथम नु विरहः सोढव्य इत्थम षठः. सो टू टाइप्स व्हाट ही सेज इज ही डजंट गिव द डेफिनेशन हियर. सो अत्र विरह असत्वं स्मरमार्गणाः एव कुर्वन्ति तदुपरि प्रियं प्रियतम दूरस्थित्यादि उपात्तम एष एव समुच्चयः सद्योगे असद्योगे सदसद्योगे च पर्यवस्यति इति न पृथक् लक्ष्यते. सो सद्योग असद्योग एंड सदसद्योग. Here, this is an example of asadyogam, in the sense ashobhananam sambandhaha. For an effect, what is the effect here? Virahaha. The separation is very difficult to bear. Na sodhavyaha. It is not possible for me to bear this viraha. What can I do this? Katham sodhavyaha. How do I bear this, tolerate this viraham? How do I tolerate this viraham? So Anayika asks her friends and says, Sakhyaha, Chaturaha, you are all very clever friends who are not clever. So she is saying, hey, this viraha is like a shatha. This is a very difficult viraham for me, this separation. How do I tolerate this viraham? There are so many reasons for that. Number one, smara marganaha durvaraha. The Manmatha's arrows are difficult to conquer. Durvaraha. It is difficult to conquer those, or the difficult to stop the marganaha arrows of smara Manmatha. So that itself is enough. Love is inevitable. And because I'm in love with this person, the effect of Manmatha's arrows are difficult for me to stop the effect of Manmatha's arrows. That one cause is enough to create a viraham in me, in the Nayika. Now she also gives extra reasons here. Priyatamaha dure. My beloved is also somewhere else. He is not close by for this viraha to be able to, you know, it can be easier when I know that my beloved is very close to me and he is going to meet me in a few hours. It may be easier for me to tolerate, but he is also somewhere else. Priyatamaha dure. Manaha ati utsukam. I am not able to entertain myself with something else. So my mind is very anxious, extremely anxious. Ati utsukam. Gadham prema. My love for him is also very deep. Not a very superficial love that I have for him. So it is extremely deep. Gadham prema navam vayaha. I'm not at a middle age where, you know, love is not the primary motivating factor for anything here. It is that young youth age where this the effect of Manmatha is even more high. So navam vayaha. Adi kathinaha pranaha. It's difficult for me to take a breath. Or another way of looking at it is adi kathinaha pranaha. Pranan is so difficult to go away from my body. It is still staying in my body in a very steadfast manner. And it is just holding on to my body. So which means my life is just so getti aisu. Abdimo, Tamil. You know, aisu romba getti. That is, you will not die quickly. So that is how my pranan is. If I die, then I'll get relieved from this viraham, right? But this pranan is adi kathinam. Kulam nirmalam. Now, my family is also very pure, very good ancestry. So, which means I cannot go and go in search of some other kamuka to relieve this viraham in me. So, kulam api nirmalam. Stritvam dhairya virodhi. This feminine character is also opposed to dhairyam. There is no natural courage that is there for me to approach him and go in search of my beloved also. So that is also not possible. See, she's giving so many reasons for the intensified separation that she feels. Manmata suhritu kalaha. Vasanta ritu is present here, which is manmata suhritu. It is the season which is Kama's friend, Manmatha's friend. Kritantaha akshamaha. This yama is also not capable. Either my pranam should go off on its own, or yama should all, he should give me death. He is also not capable of giving me death. Kritantaha akshamaha. Naha sakyaha, sakyaha no chaturaha. No chaturaha, they are na chaturaha. They are also not clever. If my friend is clever, she would have gone to that Nayaka and, you know, eduttu cholli. Adada, she could have told him her situation and tried to do something about it. That sort of a friends, clever friends also I don't have. So, sakyaha api na chaturaha. Ittham, in this manner, how can I tolerate my viraham? Katham virahaha, shataha virahaha, sodhavyaha. This viraham is like a durjanaha whom I am not able to tolerate. How do I bear the effect of viraham? So, atra viraha asahatvam smara marganaha eva kurvanti. Just that the difficult to bear, that quality of, you know, the viraham not being able to be born is something that with just the manmatha arrows can cause that. But tadupari, beyond that, you're giving so many reasons for this. So which means all of these reasons together act as reasons for just one effect, which is viraha asahattu. Eshayeva samuchayaha. Now here it is asat yogam, because asatam vastunam yogaha vartate. Asatam shobha ashobhananam. Everything is something that is not desirable. It's not a desirable vastu, right? It is ashobhanam. So ashobhananam vastunam sambandha vartate. So samuchayaha. Asat yogaha samuchayaha. The next one is sadyogaha samuchayaha. Tatahi kulam amalinam bhadra murtihi matihi shruti shalini bhujabalam alam sphita lakshmihi prabhutvam akhanditam prakriti subagahi ete bhavaha amibihi ayam jano vrajati sutaram darpam rajanna teyeva tava ankushaha. So many sad shobhananam vastunam yogaha atra udahriyante. So, kulam amalinam. My ancestry is untainted. There is no malinata in my ancestry. Bhadra murtihi. Beautiful form. So, a kavi is describing a raja and he is saying, you have all the qualities that would give arrogance to an ordinary person. But these qualities prove to be an ankusha. Ankusha or a restraint for you. It is stopping you from becoming very arrogant. Kulam amalinam. A family, pure family, that is untainted family, form which is very bhadra, auspicious, murtihi, bhadra murtihi, matihi shruti shalini, your mati, buddhi, is shalini, it is shining with the shruti, with learning. Shruti is Vedam. So, dharma shastra, shastriya buddhihi vartate. Bhujabalam, alam. Alam is enough, in the sense your strength the bhujabalam is sufficient to take care of anything. You rely only on your bhujabalam. So bhujabalam eva alam sarvasyapi. Spita lakshmihi. Lakshmihi, wealth is extensive. Spita, it is literal meaning is swollen. So here spita means it is extensive. So spita lakshmihi. And then prabhutvam akhanditam. Prabhutvam alumai. Your sovereignty is akhanditam. It is not broken. It is not obstructed by anything else. So an unobstructed rule you have. Prakriti subhagaha hi ete bhavaha. Ete bhavaha. These are all naturally good qualities. Prakriti subhagaha. Agreeable qualities. Amibihi. With these qualities. I am janaha sutaram darpam vrajati. It is natural that a person will become extremely arrogant. Sutaram darpam vrajati amibihi bhavabihi. Bhavaihi. Amibihi bhavaihi. With these qualities, a person will naturally become very arrogant. Hey Rajan, teyeva bhavaha tava ankushaha vidyante. They are actually like that ankusham which prods an elephant to, you know, the mahout uses a prod to prod the elephant to go in the right path. So these become like a restraint for you. They don't make you go in the wrong path. So all of these are sadvastu, shobhana vastu, tesham sambandaha vidyate. Iti sadyogaha samuchayaha. Next is both sat and asat yogaha. So some things will be shobhana. When there is a shobhana vastu also, the result becomes ashobhana. So that's how he has connected the sat and asat in this next shloka. It's from Niti Shatakam. Shashi divasa dusaraha galita yavvana kamini saro vigata varijam mukham anaksharam swakritehe prabhur dhanaparayanaha satata durgataha sajjanaha nripanganagataha khalaha manasi saptashalyani me. There are seven shalyam. Shalyam means it's like a dart which is just present in my mind, which is creating a wound. Shalyam is like a wedge which is constantly there, anim, nail. Something like if someone has pierced a nail into your mind and it is there, you cannot remove it also. So Shashi, divasa dusaraha, a moon which is very dim during the day. Moon by nature is a shobhana vastu, but during the day, as soon as there is sunrise or during dawn, the moon becomes very urmadri mangala arko. It becomes very dim. Its light is not prakashayuktam. So divasena dhusaraha, it becomes very dim. Dhuli yukta iva bhasate. That is like something, you know, oh, it was so beautiful till now with the night, and now it has become very dull. Right? Galita yavvana kamini, one's lover whose yavvanam has gone away. She was beautiful and very attractive during that yavvanam, but now there is a trace of that beauty, that's all. She was beautiful before, but now there is just that trace left. She's not as beautiful. So you always keep saying, you know, when you see someone in their old age who is very beautiful, you always say, imagine she's so beautiful even now, then how would she have been during youth? You always keep thinking back about the time when she would have been much more beautiful. It is not that she is ashobanam now, but there is something, that quality is less now, right? So galita yavvana kamini, it is like something which is constantly pricking in your mind. Saraha vigata varijam, a pond, a lotus pond which is without lotus. Vigata varijam mukham anaksharam su akritehe. Someone who has a beautiful form, handsome physique, yet his mouth or his words that come out are anaksharam, very illiterate. See, sometimes when someone looks very beautiful or very handsome, you expect them to be very cultured. If they turn out to be very uncultured people, it is like one something that hurts you, right? Constant hurt in your mind. Not personal hurt, it's maybe it could have been better if he was also well-read or more cultured. Prabhu dhanaparayanaha. If it is a lord, a master who is too attached to wealth and not doing any dhanam. Dhanaparayanaha. Satata durgataha sajjanaha. Sajjanaha, a good person, yet Durgataha. Durgataha, he is constantly in trouble. Or is in a very pathetic situation. He's being Daridraha, Satata Daridraha Prayaha. Nallava, you say he's a good person. Why should he always be troubled by something? He could live happily, right, because of his good actions. So that is something which pricks your mind. Nripangana gataha khalaha, a wicked person in a king's court. These are all sapta shalyani me manasi. In my mind, these are like seven darts which are constantly in my heart. Atra shashini dhusare shalye shalyantarani iti shobhana ashobhana yogaha. So how Mammatakara connects is, I don't know. The Vyakhyata is more clear than this sign. So this sentence. So I have just taken the Vyakhyata's understanding of this sloka, which is even better. Shashi shobhanaha sannapi divasa dusaraha chet ashobhanaha bhavati tadeva shalyaha. In the same way, so shalyasya shalyameva karanam bhavati shalyantarani api uktani. When you have something that is pricking in your mind, there are many different reasons for that. Shalyam has been given here. That is the samuchayam here. And those things, each one of those have a shobhana and ashobhana aspect to it. And there is a yogam of both the shobhanatvam and ashobhanatvam in one particular cause for the effect. Okay. In the same way, kaminyaha prakritya shobhana api shobhanatvam vartate. Galita yavvanatvam ashobhanatvam. In that manner, you have to connect with each of those shalyam. Okay? Shashi divasa dusaraha galita yavvana kamini saro vigata varijam mukham anaksharam swakritehe prabhur dhanaparayanaha satata durgato sadurgata sajjano dripanganagataha khalo manasi sapta shalyani me. There is another type of samuchaya where it involves guna and kriya, a quality and action. So satu anyo yugapadya gunakriya yoho yogapadyam. Samuchaya also means the happening at the same time of certain things. Okay, when two qualities are present at the same time, or when two actions are present at the same time, or when an action and a quality occur at the same time. So three types again. No, I think I have written four by mistake. That is wrong actually here. Yeah, only three types are there. That's what I remember. Yes, only three types are there. Okay, so gunakriyayaha. So gunayoho yogapadyam, kriyayoho yogapadyam, and then gunakriyayoho yogapadyam. Only these three types are mentioned. So the first one is gunayoho yogapadyam. Vidalita sagalari vigalita sagala arikulam tavabalam idam abhavat ashu vimalam cha prakhala mukani naradipa malinani cha tani jatani. Correct then, yeah, I think it is correct. Yes, okay. Gunayoho yogapadyam, and then kriyayoho yogapadyam. The third one is gunakriyayoho yogapadyam. Correct. Okay, I was just checking. So vigalita sagala arikulam tava balam idam abhavad ashu vimalam cha prakala mukani naradipa marinani chatani jatani. A kavi is describing a king. So he naradhipa vigalita tava balam idam ashu vimalam abhavat prakala mukani cha malinani jatani. Two opposing gunas have happened at the same time. One is vibalam, the other has become malinam. Vimalam is your army has become very pure. Ashu vimalam abhavat, quickly they have become very pure. In the sense, they have very quickly destroyed the arikulam, the enemies. and they have cleaned themselves, or they have become pure in the sense there is no other obstacle that can stop them. So they have free paths. Their path is unobstructed now. So Vimalam can mean so many things. Vidalita, how is that balam? How is that army, sena? Vigalita, sagala arika, kulam. Sagala, their necks of the arikulam have been, along with their necks, the entire arikulam has been destroyed. Vidalitam, they have been destroyed. Tadrisham tava balam tava sena. Idam ashu vimalam abhavate. It has become quickly, it has become purified. Tani prakala mukani, and those faces of the dushta or shatru have become malinani jatani. If someone maybe has challenged the king and said, you know, you cannot destroy them very quickly. So his army was so proficient that it quickly became pure, in the sense it destroyed the entire enemies. So the people who were trying to bet on this are the dushta, dushtaha, and their mukhani became malinani. Their faces became darkened because they felt very upset that this he had a success. They were feeling jealous. So prakhala mukhani malinani jatani cha. Here two gunam, vimalatvam and malinatvam, have happened at the same time. Even though it is happening at two different places, and it is one after the other, but the description here is as if both of those gunas have occurred at the same time. Yogapadyam gunayoho yogapadyam yugapate bhavaha yugapad. Next one is kriyayoho yogapadyam. Ayam ekapade tayaviyogaha priyaya cha upanataha sudussaha me navavaridhara udayat ahobihi bhavitavyam cha niratapat niratapatva ramyehi taya viyogaha ekapade eva. In one stroke, two things have happened here. One is taya priyaya viyogaha upanataha. A separation has occurred from that priya. So I am separated from my priya, beloved, and at the same time, nava varidhara udayat niratapatva ramyaihi bhavitavyam ahobihi. The niratapatvam, there is no adena sunlight, atapam. I'm getting confused here. Niratapatvam ahobihi, the days have also suddenly, the quickly nava varidhara udayat, because there are a lot of clouds that have come about and the days have become free without any atapa, without any heat. They have become free from heat and they have also become ramyaihi, they have become lovely. Ahobihi. See, this is, this unbearable separation has come about, and at the same time, the rainy season has also come. So upanataha and bhavi, we want the days to be beautiful, but at the same time, what has happened is I have become separated from my lover. So it is going to be an unbearable separation. So this viyogaha upanataha and ramyaihi bhavitavya ahobihi bhavitavyam, both of these kriya have, it seems like they have taken place at the same time. It is being described as taking place at the same time. So he was separated from his lover, and that separation was difficult, yes, but it has become more difficult because there is a beautiful nava varidhara udayate, because the clouds have come and the days have become more beautiful without, free of heat, without any surya tapa. Okay, ekapade eva abhavat. It is not at the same time. Suddenly the clouds just came and it became beautiful, and at the same time his wife also went. Now that cannot happen, right? When his priya is there, or when she has, when he has become separated and he has gone on a journey, on the way he has seen clouds and suddenly there are no there is no atapam and it has become beautiful. The days are beautiful. Even though it happens one after the other, he has described it as ekapade, at the same time. So samuchaya alankaram kriyayoho yogapatyam. सो तया प्रियया मे एकपदे एव सुदुस्सहः वियोगः उपनतः अहोभिः नववारिधर उदयात् निरादपत्वरम्यैः भवितव्यं च. नेक्स्ट् इस् गुण एण्ड् क्रिया क्रिययोः योगपद्यम् कलुषं च तवाहितेषु अकस्मात् सितपङ्केरुः सोदरश्री चक्षुः पतितं च महीपतीन्द्र तेषां वपुषि प्रस्फुटम् आपदां कटाक्षैः